When watching a freight train go by, all the different freight cars can get mixed in the shuffle. Whether it's a high-speed double-stack freight train, pig train, freight train rocking back and forth, or even a coal train, sometimes it can just be a freight train. But every once in a while, something unique and interesting comes by and piques your interest. Such was the case with this special move. Earlier in the day, I heard reports that a nuclear train was going through town and had armed guards in the caboose. After hearing something like this, I raced over towards Harrison Street over northeast Minneapolis to check it out. As the train rounded the curve, I was surprised to see not nuclear casks on a train, but rather a large, heavy-duty flat car carrying this unique load with Siemens Energy on it. And as the caboose came by, no armed guards, which was a relief for me. So what exactly is this piece of freight equipment that we're seeing go by? Why does it have this unique heavy-duty flat car on it, and where is it going? Let's first start off by taking a look at this unique flat car. This car has the reporting marks KWUX, and it's a 16-axle depressed center flat car, which is owned by Siemens Westinghouse Power Corp. At a length of 124 feet and 11 inches long, it can accommodate loads up to 35 feet in length, and has a load limit of a staggering 858,900 pounds. Now that we know what type of freight car this is, what exactly is this piece of equipment and where's it going? Per information, this is a piece of electrical equipment for a substation that is bound to go out west. Last I heard, it was somewhere out in North Dakota, Wyoming, or Montana. Now why is it taking this routing? This particular routing, while even though it's going east at this point, has bigger curves and more clearances to accommodate a load such as this. After the train successfully negotiated the curve over at Minneapolis Junction, we'll see the train going significantly faster as it comes through North Town Yard. And we'll get a nice view from the drone and a pace shot of this unique special load as it makes its way towards a crew change at 44th Avenue. Now, remember earlier in the video when I said I heard that there were armed guards on this caboose? There aren't any armed guards, but there are staff in this caboose, which we'll see later, which are helping to monitor the progress of this special load as it makes its way west. After a quick crew change over at 44th Avenue, I made my way over to Coon Creek. Before the train came by at Coon Creek, we'll be treated to a Z train zipping by and North Star heading west. After those two trains cleared, we'll see the special electrical load coming by. It should be noted though that even though this is a Z train, a C44-9W was leading the way, which is getting kind of hard to see on the BNSF. Mere minutes after the Z train cleared, we'll see North Star zipping past, going towards Big Lake. After the Z train and North Star cleared Coon Creek, we'll see the special electrical move coming by. Now, as it comes by in these next shots, pay special attention to the caboose. One of those staff members on it will actually see on it riding the way and enjoying the nice, cool June breeze. And that sharp-looking blue caboose we see in the tail end of this train, it's actually an ex-Burlington Northern caboose and was originally built as Fort Worth and Denver 185. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, subscribe, and comment below what you'd like to see in another video.